Hello everyone, Shadefire here, and today, to kind of cap off Aliens April, we're going to be taking a first impressions look at Alien Blackout. This is the mobile game that was announced as a sequel to Alien Isolation. And then for the short time that Fox continued to exist before being absorbed into the Disney gestalt entity, they tried to backpedal and say, no, this is actually not a sequel, it just happens to be set after Alien Isolation with the same characters. Well, really, the same character, because it's only about Amanda Ripley. Before she was then doomed to forever be just a comic book series character, since that's where the entirety of the rest of her story is in three different comic series. Anyhow, this is Blackout. Its very existence was a disappointment when it was announced, just like Diablo Immortal, because, you know, Isolation is a pretty well-regarded game, and saying that, oh yeah, we're just gonna slap together a mobile thing using some of the same assets and call it a day, was pretty disappointing, because with the way that corporate entities work, if this game didn't sell well, they would go, oh, I guess there's no interest in the IP then, we'll just never make another one. Anyhow, we're gonna get in here. If you're not aware of how this plays, it's kind of Five Nights at Ripley's. Except it's not really us we're trying to keep alive.
This is Amanda Ripley. I need urgent extraction from the Mendel Research Station. If you pick up the signal, proceed with extreme caution. There's an alien organism loose on the station. It is deadly. Repeat, deadly.
So I believe this is supposed to be a couple days after the end of Alien Isolation. I'm not really sure if there's anywhere that connects the end of that to the start of this, because she's just kind of already on the station. But she managed to go from one Xenomorph-infested station to another one. And I think the only thing that maybe connects them is there's like a YouTube digital series that recaps Isolation that might connect into this. But otherwise, you're just like, okay, I guess she's here in Mendel Station now. It's a much smaller station than Sevastopol. So the USS Halden here docks with the station, ignoring the warning that Ripley was putting out, and now we have to keep these idiots alive. Because we're here at this, like, security terminal.
Which camera is it? Come on.
And we basically just blick through cameras and control doors and stuff, and you can see we have a power limit. So yeah, it's kind of Five Nights at Freddy's, but we're juggling between
Hello.
Keeping them alive
Ripley,
and keeping
me?
Ourselves alive, because I think the Xenomorph can come
I'm
after us too.
Director Naoko Yutani. We have
not so loud. We are all in danger.
Hello?
So yeah, we have to do stuff like that. Just close doors to keep these people from getting murdered. Also, she said she's Yutani, so I guess she's a descendant of the founder of Yutani Corporation before it merged with Weyland.
There were no transmissions. The station mainframe cleared us to dock for repairs.
I'm Studwick, the engineer. And yeah, the shuttle can't go half a day without a fresh set of scrubbers.
Saito, I fly the Halden, and I'll fly you out of here if you get those parts.
You got yourself a deal.
I like how they're all doing their introductions,
There's
but they're like not even looking at the camera.
You should find some spares there.
Just looking at each other.
I'm opening the door now.
Okay, so we got this map here. You can see a bunch of flashing elements that we can open and close. So it would be helpful if I knew what these areas are. I think this is the engineering bay. Yeah, okay, so we need to get them a route there that will minimize Xenomorph contact. Now, can we see the Xenomorph? I mean, conceptually, this doesn't seem like the worst idea, it's just the license attached to it. Like, if this was just completely someone else trying to keep people alive, I would almost say that's okay, but it's kind of disappointing as a follow-up to Isolation. Does it only show me their vitals if I'm in the room? No, I guess we're paused right now. Okay, so we want to get them to engineering, so they're going to go through here. Let's close all these other doors. Any, like, non-essential ones. Also, we don't have enough power for... Okay, so closing a door takes power, which means we can only open or close a few of them.
Saiton, Stadwick, fetch the parts, please. I will stay in the shuttle with Thorncroft. Figures.
I'm afraid we're also on the clock here. Thanks to trigger-happy security, the grid was damaged. I've wired up some solar panels, but their output is limited. They're only good for 8 minutes before they shut down to charge.
So let's make them count. What do we do, Ripley?
Take a left to that control room, then bypass the lockdown and get to engineering.
Also, I'm pretty sure the blackout part of the name is, yeah, when those solar panels run out.
Engaging the lockdown. Where do you folks hold up? Ripley?
It's just me now, and I'm in the ducts, using a maintenance access point.
Everyone else is dead. Oh, Christ almighty.
The pods were launched prematurely. Some may have made it. I don't really know.
The door should open now.
Careful now. It's fast.
So, what the hell is it?
An alien organism. It lives to kill.
A station of this
and
size.
And it kills to live.
Devastated by a single entity. Seems unlikely, no matter how ferocious it is.
Panic did most of the work, but don't underestimate this thing. I've seen it do worse.
Wait! You've seen it somewhere else?
I've encountered these creatures before, and I'm still having nightmares.
I mean, again, it's
ever
only been a couple
Sevastopol
days.
Station?
Yes. There was an accidental detonation as it was being decommissioned.
Or maybe it has been longer, I'm not sure. I was pretty sure this is where she ended up after Sevastopol. This is really all we can do, is we watch them from the few cameras we have available.
Let's find those parts and get out of here. Ripley, keep an eye on the cameras.
Doing it. It's all I can do.
There's a note. Took the scrubbers, installing them soon, Greg. Thanks for getting us killed, Greg.
We can track them down. All the service orders can be accessed from the administrative hub.
You'll be needing my credentials then. Thorncroft, with me.
There's a door right next to the docking lounge, but the others should return to the shuttle first.
Got it.
Nope. It's lurking somewhere.
I hear it coming.
I mean, these are the only... Oh, wait. Why would you even leave that open, Ripley?
Ripley? Hey, Ripley! Are you okay?
Don't shout. We've made too much noise already. I had to route all the energy to the duct access. It'll come back soon. I'm trying to keep a fix on it with the cameras and the motion trackers. But I've only got this small portable unit hooked up to an access point.
You some kind of engineer as well?
Good guess. Saito, what are you doing?
Being lost. Kind of panicked there. Some directions would be nice.
I was gonna say, if she's in the vent, then she's pretty vulnerable. Where is Saito? I think this is her here?
Saito.
Okay. I mean, go this way, I guess.
Head over that way.
Thanks, Ripley.
Don't rely on me guiding you all the time. That creature tracks human voices, and those really travel in the ducts.
Okay.
Also, no running if you can avoid it.
So he's right here, I guess. But that door's closed, so we don't have to worry. Is he just standing in front of the door?
That devil's close.
I mean, I guess I can leave the motion tracker on until I need to close the door. Maybe don't go that way yet.
Ripley, open this thing.
I mean, I don't think you want to go that way yet. Let me check. Oh, okay, now you want to go that way.
Hey, Ripley, heard something.
Yep. Well, that's a shame. I guess I should open that door.
I think we've misplaced our trust.
Nah, he's fine.
I can't control that creature. I can only track it. And I don't know if I'm your best bet, but right now I'm the only bet you have. So keep it together and we'll make it through this.
Just try not to get any more of us killed, okay?
I mean, she's like detecting it here, but like, if it's in the entrance, you're fucked. I can't help you there. Yeah, just lurking outside the door.
Shall we then?
Yes, Miss Yutani.
Okay, so they need to get here?
Thorncroft, go there now.
Okay, now we have options to tell them what to do. Why was I telling him to get over here?
The admin hub isn't too far, but I'll need to move to a new access point. I'll let you know once I'm connected again.
Before you go...
I'm just gonna lock her in there.
Have you worked here for long?
The crew pulled me out of a bad situation and brought me here, actually. But when I came out of hypersleep, most of them were already dead. Did you know what they had cooking here?
Are you suggesting weyland-yutani created that creature?
No, but this one was born here, all right. We can talk about it after. For now, let's chatter.
How dare you accuse weyland-yutani of doing something with xenomorphs? You and your new crew head to the administrative hub to find where the scrubbers have been taken. I thought I was going to have to, like, crawl through the vent. So yeah, do I just have to complete this game without them all dying?
All my life, and with the science division since I was 16. I've never seen anything as preposterous as this at any of the labs.
So a scientist, then. I didn't get your name.
Andrew Thorncroft, yes.
But you're not part of the weapons division.
Sure. The information will be on one of the workstations here. With all due respect to your credentials, we still need a crew ID for those.
I do know how these places work, Amanda. I have been personally in charge of 4 now.
Right. I'd start by checking any uniforms you can find.
Like, for the type of game this is, I actually don't think this plays too badly. It's simply the fact that it's a sequel to Isolation that makes it disappointing. Like, again, if this was a different station with different characters, but, you know, still handling a xenomorph, that would be alright. It's just kind of sucks for Amanda that this is where she gets stuck. Alright. So I guess we'll continue into this level. I don't think we've been going for too long yet, but I do want to keep this a little short so I could try to actually get it out before midnight. Since I'm recording this the same day. Alright. So, do we want to try to multitask them? I would say that we should probably send both of them up here and then send one of them over here. Or do I just have to click? We didn't have a blackout, so I wonder if that just means that...
Thorncroft.
That's kind of a timer for the level. I should also turn the motion trackers on. So yeah, I think this yellow dot here is me. Okay, so it's locked off here. It's a good thing I closed that door. Pretty sure it's gonna come for me, though.
I found some of the crew. Occupants. The smells.
Damn it. I was trying to get back to me. I was like trying to click the center dot to get to a camera, but there's no camera there. You just have to click off of the area. Alright, so...
I've been with the company all my life, and with the science division since I was 16. I've never seen anything as preposterous as this at any of the labs.
So a scientist, then. I didn't get your name.
Andrew Thorncroft, yes. Can we proceed?
Sure. The information will be on one of the workstations here. With all due respect to your credentials, we still need a crew ID for those.
I do know how these places work, Amanda. I have been personally in charge of 4 now.
Right. I'd start by checking any uniforms you can find.
So where is the 3rd person? Because there was 4 people on the ship. We lost 1. So, I guess the other one's still in the shuttle?
Thorncroft.
Alright, let's get all these motion trackers going. Just kind of lurking around up there for now. I can lock it in, but there's still a vent that leads right to me. Nope. Denied. He's gonna go right for the vent. Probably gonna come for me. But we can handle that.
I've found some of the crew.
Oh.
The smell is powerful.
He's coming.
This is distasteful, but also our best opportunity. Please, mind the cameras. MDL-37231. Thank you, Mr. Pembroke.
Oh.
And,
Now for that workstation.
I was trying to send them down here, but I don't think I can control them while they're still doing their objective.
Thorncroft!
It's safe.
It's not safe.
It is close.
Yeah, so I think they're not going to survive this level. I don't know how I'm supposed to keep it from coming up through here, though. I guess I was supposed to tell them to hide. I didn't realize that was an option while they were in there. And I've got cameras in the places that I don't have motion trackers. I mean, I'm not getting anything. Where are you hiding?
That was close.
The real surprise is that that little vent cover can keep it out. If that was the case, you think it wouldn't have spread around the station in the first place? Alright. How are you doing in there? I don't see her.
Locating that work order now.
Oh. Tell you to hide.
Johnny, hide now.
Okay. It didn't see her, I guess.
It's safe.
So yeah, I suppose I want to keep the motion trackers on at all times. Until I really need to close some doors.
The parts are in former Lab 3. I'm afraid we'll have to go deeper into the station.
Using the transit link is our best option, but we'll need all hands.
Well, we don't have very many hands left.
Everyone catch that.
Barely. Meet you at the transit link.
Can I just... Can I just annoy it by opening and closing this door? I think eventually it will go into the vent instead, yeah. He's like, I'm not fucking around with that. And if he's in the vent, he might come for me, or he might drop down in here. Didn't even see her die. Yeah, so I could have saved her if I closed that door fast enough. For a moment, I thought she was out of range.
I've been with the company all my life.
I think we can beat this level before we finish the video, though.
16. I've never seen anything as preposterous as this at any of the labs.
So a scientist, then. I didn't get your name.
Andrew Thorncroft, yes. Can we proceed?
Sure. The information will be on one of the workstations here. With all due respect to your credentials, we still need a crew ID for those.
I do know.
Kinda wish I could skip their dialogue, though.
Amanda, I have been personally in charge of 4 now.
Right. I'd start by checking any uniforms you can find.
See, I could set them in the middle, but that's like the least defensible spot because it has so many doors that I would need to close, so I think it's better to send them up here. But yeah, like, I almost want to say that this plays pretty decently on a PC, because it's obvious how it's meant for a tablet, you know, just having touch controls and nothing else, but I think it works just as well on a PC. So, you know, maybe this is changing my mind about this being okay, at least, a little bit.
I found some of the crew in body bags. The smell is...
And maybe after that isolation LP, we'll try giving this a full playthrough.
But also, our best opportunity. Please, mind the cameras.
I can't even see them on the cameras. I thought maybe I could, like, move the camera, but no.
MDL37231. Thank you, Mr. Pembroke. And...
No!
Well.
Thorncroft!
I guess, I was gonna say, how did it get in there without setting off any of the motion detectors, but it would have dropped from that vent exit right there. Hello?
I think I heard something.
Yutani. No, it's so fast.
I should have been the one hiding. See, I knew it was coming, because there was like some clanking and everything, and then I thought, oh, maybe it went after her instead, and I'm hearing that over the camera. Oh. Whoops.
I've been with the company all my life, and with the science division since I was 16. I've never seen anything as preposterous as this at any of the labs.
So a scientist, then. I didn't get your name.
Andrew Thorncroft, yes. Can we proceed?
Sure.
Why did he say yes at the end there?
One of the workstations here. With all due respect to your credentials, we still need a crew ID for those.
I do know how these places work, Amanda. I have been personally in charge of 4 now.
Right. I'd start by checking any uniforms you can find.
Alright, let's see if we can keep these idiots alive this time. Let's go this way. Yep, just go straight for it. You don't want to go in that vent, you want to take the easy way. Look, the door's open. Just come right out. I just want to see how much I can hassle the Xenomorph. Okay, he went into the vent. He's venting.
Thorncroft.
I think it's going to go after Thorncroft, so I'm going to close that door.
It appears they use this space as a temporary morgue, with no cooling. A perfect place to find a crew ID. Monitor the cameras while I search.
I need to look elsewhere.
So I think it's coming for me.
MDL-37231. Pembroke, like the dog.
Now for that workstation.
I guess that means they also all have a... Oh.
Thorncroft.
They all have a voice line for completing the objective.
Yutani.
I hear it.
Well, one thing I wish is that... hiding places were actually marked on the map, because I thought, oh, okay, he's in this room, there's gotta be somewhere to hide. And then he just fucking wandered over the door. So clearly there was not a place to hide.
It's safe.
Okay, I'm pretty sure if I can hear him, that means he's coming for me. I mean, I'm still watching the screen as I'm looking over at this vent.
I hear it moving.
Hide now.
I don't trust it. I still think it's coming for me.
That was close.
If the Xenomorph is so intelligent, do you think it would just know that I'm here still, and it would just wait, or find another way in here? Alright, how's it going, Yutani?
Come out.
I wish you could move the cameras, too. Like, I feel like there's just a tiny bit not enough control over the circumstances here. Okay, it's going up. I'm not going to close the door, because then it'll go straight for the vent. I'm just going to let it wander around for a bit. That's it. Just keep yourself busy. Because if it goes in the vent, it can drop straight into the offices. Well, it looks like it's going to do that anyway.
Locating that work order now.
Hide.
And tell her to go into hiding until we find out where it's going. But yeah, like, I can't even see where she is in this room. I think she's back there. I heard some more clanking in the vent. Might be coming for us again.
It's safe.
It's safe, because I don't think it's after you.
Deeper into the station.
Using the transit link is our best option, but we'll need all hands on deck. Everyone catch that?
Barely. Meet you at the transit link.
No, that's her. I was like, that thing's moving pretty fast. No, that actually is not her.
Yutani, hide.
You should probably hide. He's lurking. That boy be lurking. And strutting. Kind of sliding around. Hey, pal.
Come out.
Okay, he's in the vents again. So he went into this vent here, which means he can come for me, but he'd have to go all the way around to the middle. Which sounds like that's exactly what he's doing. Oh, it's gonna drop on her head.
Hide now.
Good hiding spot.
Ripley! Ripley!
Too late. Can't help you. You're all dead. You and your friends are dead. All right, let's give it one more shot, I guess.
I've been with the company all my life, and with the science division since I was 16. I've never seen anything as preposterous as this at any of the labs.
Like, I like the idea of having control of the systems and, you know, you're trying to open and close doors as it goes. Apparently, the entire concept for this game was based on that one fucking scene from Alien Covenant where David, the super boring android, is locking doors to funnel the Xenomorph. Actually, was that Covenant or was that Prometheus?
Right. I'd start by checking any uniforms you can find.
Wasn't that Prometheus with the trilobite once it was loose? But yeah, one of the two. And they said, oh, wouldn't that be cool if that was a video game? And then somehow that ended up with, hey, let's do that with Alien Isolation.
Thorncroft.
Also, I wonder if this changes every time. Like, what actual body has the... has the thing on it. What's the point of this room right here? Like, I feel like the hiding mechanic and these little safety rooms would be more useful if I could directly tell them to go there, but the only time you can actually tell them to go to a specific spot seems to be when there's an objective.
Looking for a crew ID.
It appears they use this space as a temporary morgue with no cooling. A perfect place to find a crew ID. Monitor the cameras while I search.
We need to look.
Yeah, so there's a hiding spot right next to the objective. Okay, well, don't go that way.
Hide now.
She's like hiding right next to me. So I think they can hide indefinitely. I don't think he's gonna find them like he can in Isolation if you hide too much. Okay, looks like he went up here. But again, let's wait till we have some idea which way he went. Because I didn't get a ping from this side, so that means he must have gone that way. Okay, he's back in that room.
Thorncroft, come out.
Yeah, it almost seems like it's better to keep one of them in hiding at all times until we're ready to send them both somewhere.
Yutani. It's safe.
MDL 37231. Pembroke, like the dog.
Now for that workstation. Hide, Thorncroft. Hide now.
Because it went to the vents, so I think telling them to hide when it's in the vents is a good idea. Since we can't track it. I think it's coming after me. Yeah, I'm not getting pings anywhere. Here it comes. No? Yes?
Yutani. Come out.
I think she's fine. Pretty sure it's still gonna show up where I am. Nope. That was corridor. it's going this way, which means she,
Yutani.
Might want to hide.
Hide. Thorncroft.
Okay, he's just kind of skulking around. Now he's going into the vents.
Come out.
Thorncroft, you should probably hurry up.
Now.
Yeah, like, it seems like there's a lot of hiding spots. So I don't know what happened to him that time when he went down here and then just stood there while he died.
Yutani.
And you can't be too cautious like this, because that's, I guess, the reason for the blackout timer is, if you take too long, everything's going to shut off and then everyone's going to die.
Come out. Head that way.
Thorncroft is hidden, right? Like, it's not going to find him. Or is that me I should be worried about? Also, it looks like I can actually set their path. I just can't click a destination. Oh, yeah, don't go, Don't go in there yet.
Now.
It's occupied. Occupado. Okay, Thorncroft, that means you can go for now. Hmm. It must have vented again.
Hide, Yutani. Come
on. Because otherwise we would have... Oh, that's me. I wonder if I did that too early?
That was close.
Like, I'm just waiting for the time where she's like, that was close, and then it opens and it's right there. Okay. Thorncroft sees it, but he, again, should be fine because he's hiding.
The parts are in former Lab 3. I'm afraid we'll have to go deeper into the station.
Using the transit link is our best option, but we'll need all hands on deck.
Okay, it sounds like it's right next to him.
Barely. Meet you at the transit link.
Okay, so now we just need to get to the transit link. And it's still hanging out there. So yeah, we'll keep sending her this way. And then, oh, rejected.
2 minutes.
I think we can do this in 2 minutes. He's gonna hopefully wander around this way. Okay, sprinted all the way up here. I think he went straight for the vent.
Go there.
No, seems like he's still hanging around. Yeah, he was just kind of like standing in there. Kind of wish there was a distraction option, you know, like maybe something I could set off in one of these rooms to create noise. Okay, he's going into corridors, so... Thorncroft, you're gonna want to go here.
Come out.
Lock the boy in. Now he's probably gonna sprint around here. Nope. He's just shuffling, so.
We got a minute to go. Head that way.
I'm just waiting for it to fucking drop out of the vent right in front of him.
Yutani.
Well, hide then. Before it comes out of the vent.
Hide now.
Okay, so I think he's about here. Shit.
30 seconds.
Well.
It's safe. 15 seconds! Move it!
She's gonna need to hurry up.
Yutani. Run! Thorncroft.
Okay. Let me guess, it's just gonna come from me immediately. Without power, Amanda's refuge becomes her tomb, just like when you run out of power in Five Nights at Freddy's and can't close the door. So yeah, clearly you can see the influences this game has, but it's all right for that type of game. Certainly better animated than Five Nights at Freddy's, that's for sure. But, I think maybe that'll be it. I was hoping to at least get through the second level, but considering it takes up to 8 minutes per level, maybe we can, like, speedrun this, just tell them to fucking run all the way.
So a scientist, then. I didn't get your name.
Andrew Thorncroft, yes. Can we proceed?
Sure.
Let's just play this fast and loose one more time and see how it goes.
With all due respect to your credentials, we still need a crew ID for those.
I do know how these places work, Amanda. I have been personally in charge of four now.
Right? I'd start.
Yeah, like not being able to skip this sucks. Okay, let's turn all the motion trackers on. He's hanging out up there.
Thorncroft. Run!
Thorncroft, go as quickly as you fucking can.
Yutani. Hide. Thorncroft.
Is he still running?
Hide now, Yutani. It's safe.
No, wait.
Go there now. Go there now, Thorncroft.
I hate that there's no camera in this room. Okay, he's hanging out by Thorncroft, so yeah, Yutani.
Yutani.
Hurry up.
Go, go, go. Thorncroft.
No!
Wait, no.
It's safe.
It's not safe.
Hide now.
So, like, she auto-hid that time, so she knew he was nearby.
Thorncroft.
No, get out of here.
It appears they use this space as a temporary morgue, with no cooling. A perfect place to find a crew ID. Watch the cameras.
Sorry, can't do that. My power has been shut off.
Yutani, it's safe.
MDL-37231, Pembroke, like the dog.
Now for that workstation.
Okay, no, you don't need to hide.
Yutani.
Okay, maybe we Thorncroft. Just get Thorncroft down near the exit. And then tell him to hide.
Come out. Yutani. Go there, now.
Because there's no vent exit on this side, so if he hangs out near the door, he should be all right. In fact,
okay,
we send him in here.
Now.
Oh, well.
I hear it.
Hide now.
You coming for me again?
The parts are in former Lab 3. I'm afraid we'll have to go deeper into the station.
Using the transit link is our best option. But we'll need all hands on deck. Everyone catch that.
Barely. Meet you.
Okay, I think we can get this real quick. Oh, shit. Okay, he is there. It's weird that it switches to a white dot sometimes.
Thorncroft. Hide.
He's just gonna stand at that door? I think he's going up through here. Oh, he's hanging out in that room. Which is good for us, because now, when he tries to get out through the vent, we can send him up and around.
It is close.
Relax. Trust me, if the door's closed, it's closed for a good reason. Okay, he's in the ducts now, so...
Go there, now.
Thorncroft, come out.
Everybody get the fuck out of there.
Head that way.
I'm not really sure when you can tell them to hurry up. I guess if I hit sneak?
Slow down. Run!
So that's something I wasn't really managing before. Alright, you guys just... I don't think I actually told them to go to the objective. I just sent them in front of it.
Alright, I need to switch access points again. Before I go, I just wanted to ask, are you the Miss Yutani?
Merely her second cousin. It is a powerful name to bear, with many responsibilities.
Just like there are many identical Weylands. Some of them are androids, some of them are not. And some of them are maybe androids, like the one from Alien 3. Alright, so I think that's a good look at Alien Blackout. It's actually not too bad. I was expecting it to be worse. You know, it's hard not to be cynical about it because of how it was created, but...
Damn it, Dougal.
It seems okay.
How am I gonna do this without you?
The camera at the platform isn't working. You'll need to check if the train is there.
Can I have some
I don't know how long this is.
You'll have backup soon, but we need to check out the platform
But at the
first.
Very least, this is a single-purchase type game without any, you know, microtransactions. Hey, buy some more power for this level if you're having trouble. No, it's just, it's $5. So, yeah, this seems all right. I revoke my super cynicism for it and just kind of leave mild distaste. I really do hope that someday Isolation gets a follow-up, but then again, how many adventures can Amanda Ripley have in her life before she ends up back on Earth to die of cancer? Anyhow, I've been Shadefire. This is Alien Blackout. Thank you for joining me. And hopefully you enjoyed Aliens April. She certainly didn't. But yeah, I had fun with it. It was something I wish I had decided to do a little sooner instead of like 2 days before the start of April. But, you know, I got like what, about 50 videos released this month? So I think that's pretty good for me. Anyhow, you folks all take care and we'll be returning to Amanda's story at some point this year. I can guarantee it. But until then, y'all take care.